So next up, I'd like to introduce Martin and Eileen to do a joint presentation on the Rich North Sea program.
Yeah, thank you. Okay, so good afternoon, everyone, and thank you for this opportunity to be part of this interesting session. My name is Maarten Loobrecht, and I'm joined here today with Eline van Onselen. I'm a project manager at the Rich North Sea Project, and Eline is our marine ecologist. Okay, so the Rich North Sea, it's an initiative in Holland where we aim to restore nature in wind farms in the North Sea. As you maybe know, it's one of the most used seas in the world, by, among others, transport, fishery, oil and gas, and lately by wind energy. And the nature, biomass, and biodiversity is under pressure because of all those industries. And therefore, this program aims to enhance nature and help nature to fight back in this heavily used sea. And why in the wind farms? As you can see on the picture on the right, you have this wind turbine. That's what we see above the sea level. However, there are so many opportunities for marine life that can attach to the structures, as you can see at the bottom picture, or even attach on the scour protection, which you can see on the picture in the middle left. So what do we do? This program aims to enhance nature in several wind farms in the North Sea by putting artificial reefs in these wind farms. And just one more thing about the wind farms, as Peter McCready told you, these are perfect hotspots for biodiversity. It's also a large area, these wind farms. The newest wind farms in the Dutch Sea are up to 250 squared kilometers. So these areas are huge and full potential. So we do not only put artificial reefs, as you can see in the middle and in the top picture in the sea, we also monitor them with several techniques, and also test new structures in several labs. At the next slide, this is a project. Currently, we have six offshore projects, which you can see on the left. All these wind farms are partners of this program, and each of these projects have special, I would say, unique opportunities and unique species that we would like to focus on. For instance, cod, lobsters, flat oysters, etc. And then this is joined by our team of scientists and ecologists like Eline that aim to further research the development of these species there. So Eline, if you could take over.
Definitely. Thank you, Maarten. So the program actually launched in January of this year. So right now we're in the middle of planning our activities. And there's actually a lot to plan. And some of our projects are already in the water, so to say. We're actually setting up six different offshore projects, as you can see in this slide. And they're all in Dutch offshore wind farms, so on the in the Dutch North Sea. We aim to use the learning by doing a principle. So we not only try to do proper research, we also try to really do some practical learning. So with different objectives, with different research questions in each project, we really try to kickstart offshore reefs to monitor results, but also really to share our findings. And that's something that we really stand for. Some of the wind farms or the industry partners that we work with, the wind farms are already in place. Some still have to be built. So there's a lot of opportunities there where we can either have a clean slate, so to say, to have some T0 monitoring, or with which we can compare some older wind farms which are already in place. So that's also very interesting. So next to the six projects in offshore wind farms, we also have one offshore innovation lab. It's a piece, or well, I would say a piece of land, but it's a piece of sea, which we rent. and it's closer to shore than the offshore wind farms. It's a lot easier to go back and forth. So we can actually test some of our projects there. So for example, some artificial reefs. In Dutch offshore wind farms, it's actually not allowed to go diving. And diving can be a very valuable monitoring asset. And we can actually dive in our offshore innovation lab. So this is also something we really want to make use of. We're also aiming to create our own flat oyster hatchery for use in our own nature enhancement project. And this is also something you can see in the middle of this slide, which is the source material. Flat oyster is actually almost extinct in our own North Sea, in the Dutch North Sea. There are some populations left, but it's very, very small. And if we want to enhance this species, we really need good source material. So that's why we're starting our own hatchery. And we are, and we want to be collaborating with the offshore sector, as well as with other NGOs and scientific institutes. And in our opinion, this is not something that we should do alone. There's already a lot of knowledge out there, but there's also a lot of knowledge gaps. And there's a lot of questions still floating around, but there's also a lot of know-how. And we really want to be able to put all the players together and really produce something which is practical and useful. And that's why we thought of the toolbox. So that's something you see here at the lower part of the screen. And the toolbox will be an online environment in which we want to share all the knowledge and all the results that we accumulate over time. So the project will run in total 4 years, but we're already planning to do some monitoring after these 4 years as well. And everything we do, the lessons learned, the research objectives, the results, everything will be published in this toolbox. And the toolbox will not only be interesting for example, scientists, but we really want to make it useful and practical for the industry as well. Our dream and our goal is really to make nature enhancement part of the industry, to really fuse nature and offshore wind. And the only way to do that is to really, make a good cooperation between these two, to make it a logical step, to make it easy to implement. And this toolbox will really help doing this by creating a practical platform, which is available to, well, pretty much anyone who's interested. So here on this slide, you actually see the projects on which we are working. So the offshore wind farms that are already built are actually red in this picture. There are some, you can actually, if it's okay to see, it's quite small actually. But there are some that are already there for a couple of years. The blue ones are being installed. And then there's the green areas, which are planned areas, so to say. So there's no building plans there yet. But there might be in the future. So right now the projects are indicated with a star, and these are all the locations that we're working on right now. And as you can see on the left, well, we have quite a long list already of project partners, which we work together with. We also try to extend our cooperation cross-border, because we put all these nice borders in the North Sea, but well, nature doesn't really adhere to that. So we really want to look at North Sea as a whole. So we're already creating projects, for example, with the UK and with Belgium. We want to make a sort of opportunity maps, for example, to indicate what kind of wildlife is there, what the seafloor looks like, and what would happen if you would put, for example, an offshore wind farm there, how you would change the communities and the habitats, and if this would be useful or not for a certain species. So that's very interesting and something that we're really looking forward to. I could probably talk about this for hours on end. I think I'll pass it back to Maarten to wrap it up.
Yeah, thank you, Elina. I will stop sharing in a moment. I think we can say that currently wind energy and nature enhancement goes hand in hand. That's also an English phrase. And I think there are many opportunities and possibilities for other man-made structures to enhance biodiversity, not only in the North Sea, but also in Australia and all the other parts in the world. Thank you.